Previously on 13 Sentinels, Aegis Rim.
Seriously, holy shit. What happened to What kind of gross work did you get from between now and then? She's adorable as hell right now, but like seriously, between now and then she goes from like a A or B cup to a fucking E cup. It's like, Jesus. Iori, whatever you do, stop drinking milk, all right? You're fine. You're just fine. This is gonna save you some serious back problems down the line.
But I just love it so much!
She just grabs a whole gallon and is like, ah! No, stop that.
And now back to...
The f*** is this? What's that? The f*** are you?
Ah! Hello!
NicoB! Back with some more 13 Sentinels Aegis Rim. When we last left off, we got stuck in a time loop with the art with our boys and freaking crepes and Sundays and Mr. Kitty and oh my god!
But yeah, so you guys did tell me that it's one of the few negatives of this game. There's a few things that are like kind of stand out in this game. One is that occasionally there'll be times where it's a little obtuse about how you're supposed to progress. Apparently I was not the only one that got stuck at that moment, by the way. Other people had that exact same problem where you're like, what the fuck? What does the game want me to do? It's like trying to understand the rules they're setting in place here. Like you think you understand it and then the game's like, no, you're doing it wrong. And I think I get it now. It's basically like once you started like a branch of whatever a conversation is or something, you just gotta wait till the next branch to hop into it, but you can't necessarily do it from another branch, right? Like, so basically, if I did the Mr. Kitty one, it basically resetted us back to square one again. Then I had to listen to their first conversation, then I had to progress from there, then to the next conversation about crepes and sundaes and blah, 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 blah. But I couldn't do it from the Mr. Kitty conversation, get to the crepes one. I think. So it's kind of weird. And you gotta be, I think, patient a bit. And the other thing too is that I'm now coming to see is that all these characters with hard to say Japanese names also appear to have other hard to say Japanese names. Like apparently Shio Amaguchi has another name, Tenya Ida. And Iori's name is Chihiro Miyamura as well. Like maybe that's like the real name. So it starts getting a little confusing and it's actually made me wonder if every one of these characters is gonna have like the real self. I imagine that some of these guys are just who they were, right? I feel like Takatashi out of everybody, because he seemingly came from the WW2 era, like seems to be who he says he is, right? But maybe some of these high school students, right? Maybe they are not who they thought. And it seems like Iori must have also had her memories erased at some point, right? I don't know, but for what purpose? What purpose would they... Why would they go to the trouble of doing that and putting him back in high school when clearly they seem to need to be the ones to save the world? I don't know. So I have to uncover that. But yeah, time loops and getting stuck in time loops and confusing names aside, I am very much enjoying this game. I want to play more, man. I want to play fucking more and see what the hell's going on. By the way, you guys did also clarify another thing, and that is apparently... So the idea behind, first off, this flowchart, even the way that I ended up saying it after you guys told me about it, still wasn't entirely right. So I was like, okay, well, clearly this is just like, I do these eventually, but like maybe they go chronology from like top to bottom or something, you know, like in a full day. It's not even that. The idea behind this is that every time you start in this point, you are essentially starting a brand new day. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's the same day as when you did some of these other ones. It might be, but it might be a totally different day. It's how I can manage to go and talk with Iori one day, and then another day go to the cafeteria looking for Amaguchi, and then another day I go find him in the break area, you know? The point is, you are doing all these things, right? But not necessarily a single day. You're doing it over time. And while it might seem like, well, why is everything playing out the same at the start of this day? It's because, according to you guys, it's supposed to simulate that sort of samey feeling of high school life, which is, I mean, I think we can all relate to that, right? Honestly, any school life, where after a while you get set in your routine and the days can start to kind of blend together a bit. It also explains how when Shiba came in that one day and I was like, oh, I know where he is. He's in the break room and we just go. I was like, wait, how did that happen? Alternate world lines or some shit? No, it's just a different day. It's another day. And that other day where I learned where he was, where he would be, we decided to investigate that current day. It's kind of weird and it's definitely a bit confusing to understand. And they for sure did not do a good job explaining here. Like, I don't even think they really didn't explain it at all here. Like, I would honestly have thought that this was some kind of crazy world line bullshit, but And I'm guessing you guys probably either you figured this out yourself just by playing through the game, like you somehow managed to piece that together, which if you did, I'm fucking impressed. Or people asked the developers about it and they explained it. I don't know where you got the information that that's how this works, but I don't know if I ever would have figured that out, to be honest. I probably would have played it all the way to the end of the game, and then by the end I would have been like, wait, so then what was the, how did this work? Was it alternate world lines or not? What's happening? But the other thing too is that apparently the game doesn't always tell you what you need to do. So these I actually can do now. Like the game will explicitly tell you when you can't move forward. Otherwise you can go ahead and do these. It just, for some reason, the game's not telling me what I need to do exactly to do it. I'm not sure why exactly. I thought the idea behind this was that, oh, okay, I'm not seeing what it's not telling me specifically, oh, you got to do this thing in order for it to work, right? Yeah, it's weird. Why is it? So, like, this one's orange. Like, do the colors mean anything? Why is this one orange and this one's blue? And the orange ones seem to be the ones with the, yeah. The orange ones are the, and actually I guess the red ones too, are the ones with summaries. I guess they're like, maybe there's like transitionary things where nothing significant happens. I thought what it was doing was it was giving me tips on what I should do, right? To get to unlock the thing. I mean, it does give me the keys and stuff, but I think these ones just mean that I don't need, there's no key or anything that I need specifically to move to that next one, right? I just gotta do something, but I'm gonna have to figure out what that is. So, okay, all right. Okay, I think I understand, hopefully, maybe. But I'll probably go back and do the rest of Juro's then, or at least of those, just because I do kind of want to just see what's going on and hopefully try to figure it out too, because I'll likely be dealing with a lot of that for the majority of this game. But anyway, last episode, Blargle Snarf said, me. Oh, hey, I understand this thing now. Literally anything. Me. Oh, hey, I don't understand this thing or anything else now. Yeah, yeah. I still know how this game kind of feels. Like, you start to feel like you understand the story some, and then like some new thing gets tossed in, and they're like, oh wait, no, I don't get it at all. And that actually extends also to some of the gameplay of this, right? How the story is told through the flow chart, progressing through like character conversations, getting keywords and stuff. Even that kind of feels the same, where I'm like, okay, I think I understand how this gameplay mechanic works. Oh wait, no, I don't understand it at all. This comment perfectly encompasses this game in a nutshell. But Blargle Snarf, thank you so much for your honestly accurate as fuck comment. And it's for that reason you are comment of the day. But okay, so we progressed a little bit through Iori's, barely. Hers started getting a bit confusing as well. Oh yeah, so we had the choice between crepes and soft serve. And that looks like, is it just end there? I'm guessing at some point you get through it and then it's just gonna unlock a bunch of new stuff. I think. Because I'm only 28% of the way through hers. But I want to hop back into Juro's again, and I want to see if I can figure out where some of these are. So let's go back to... Oh, okay, I get it. For this one, get rid of Shiba. So I need Shugamaguchi and stack of papers. I actually used only Shugamaguchi for that one, where I talked to Iori in the hallway, right? But I didn't use the stack of papers, and I think the stack of papers is I could have lost him in the classroom, had him go deliver that for me, and then moved on. Right. Another thing you guys told me that I should keep in mind is I can actually use the skip button for green dialogue or something. Like, so if I end up like going through my stuff, because it is kind of hard to figure out which things you've already thought about, right, and seen the fluff dialogue for. If I wanted to skip that, I can just hold down the skip button, and if I come across anything that I haven't seen before, then the game won't skip through it, right, because I do have that enabled, I believe. Okay, cool. Good idea. Okay, so I can just hop here. Oh, no, I have to hop. Okay, so no, I guess, okay, you have to start the day from the beginning, don't you? Okay. And I can't just hop to the next... I cannot. Okay. I hadn't really tried actually to just go like, oh wait, can I just hop to the next thing? I can't really know. But I imagine at some point then I'll have a new branch that I start, right? That goes down here. That'll be another brand new day or series of days that I go through stuff. Okay. So let's get rid of Shiba at the start here.
Bad news, Juro.
So yeah, so I can hold this down, booga booga booga. Let's get the stack of papers. Big titty Iori, forgot them again.
Would you like to get crepes on our way home?
Oh, I got crepes, I got PTSD. All right, hey, take my stack of papers and get the shit out of here.
Sorry, Shiba-kun. I have to drop off these papers.
Again? Jeez. Well, just meet me at the front gate when you're done. In the meantime, I'll go hunt down Amiguchi.
Amiguchi, yeah!
All right. Oh, wait, we got a... Oh, wait, that's these a stack of papers? Or is it? Oh, shoot at Dream?
In my dream.
Oh, this is new.
Back in time to prevent the extinction of humanity. To do that, we had to blow up some sort of research facility. And, well, we did it. And if that weren't enough, we shot the researchers dead. The woman I was with in that dream looked eerily similar to Fuyusaka-san.
And this happened before she came and shot him in the back, right? Like when he went and killed Amaguchi and everybody else, which probably means he came to some sort of realization between when he saw her at the factory and when that happened, that he felt like he needed to do that. And that's why she's like, what the fuck are you doing? So everything else, if I consider just hold down the, yeah.
Woo!
Oh God, I'm so glad. Look how fast that is too.
Woo, woo, woo.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I do think the UI could have used some improvement though. Like, I feel like this shit, like, it seems obvious that the things that you considered, like, why have them highlighted green? Have like the one thing that you haven't seen before be highlighted a different color, at least. All right, let's grab my bag.
Juro.
Oh.
You'll be home for dinner, right? I'll cook something for you.
Hey, watch what you're saying.
Is this all still same?
For tonight, I'm thinking hamburg steak. Your favorite.
Oh, God.
Knock it off. If people find out we're living together, we'll be expelled from school.
This is new.
Is that so? I don't mind.
Ah!
Well, I do mind. So please.
Wait, you get expelled from school for that? What?
Sorry.
Damn, Yakushi, she has such the hots for him.
I'll be a little more discreet.
Okay, I did get something new for that.
Don't stay out too late. I'll be waiting for you.
Okay, so I actually managed to talk to her that time, because last time I had Shiba-kun on my ass, so I couldn't actually really talk to her like that.
Feels awkward going home like this. I'm gonna be restless all night. We're just teenagers. We can't be living together already.
I'm gonna be horny all night.
What is she thinking? Just showing up at my place and treating me like this?
Oh, okay, yes. So these are the two different events. One is gonna be going to Miss Mary Murrah's probably nurse's office, right? And then the other one is this, where I can actually recall this. So I actually finally learned what she's doing there. I still didn't figure that out yet. A few weeks ago, Karabe House living room.
That's strange. The front door was unlocked. I hope there wasn't a break-in.
She's just naked in an apron over here. I'm like, oh God.
Hey, baby.
Huh? You're from my school, right? I think we're in the same.
Oh.
It's been 40 years. I've missed your touch.
Oh, fuck.
Hold on, back up.
Slow the fuck down.
What are you doing in my house?
I'll be renting a room starting today. My name is Megumi Yakushiji. Hello there.
You're joking, right?
40 years?
I spoke with your landlord, Tamao Karabe. She gave me this rental agreement.
My grandma?
I've already moved in my furniture.
Jeez. I mean, yeah, there was.
She's like, what the fuck? It's too fast.
And she said she was planning to rent it out, but.
You two horny kids have fun!
A girl from school. What were you thinking, Grandma? There's no way. I can't do this. Grandma's going to be out this whole month. She's visiting relatives back in Shimane. That means it's just the two of us here. If the school finds out, we're going to be expelled.
Well, that wouldn't be so bad.
What?
Anyway, I need to get started on dinner. As thanks for letting me stay with you, I'll be taking care of your meals.
I'll let you touch one of my boobs.
Hmm.
Hey, wait.
Wow, she's super forceful. wonder Juro's so freaked out. I mean, I get the whole idea of like, well, oh God, big teeters.
Karabe-kun?
Huh? I may get the idea of he just want to kill her because of the nightmare or something, but...
You seem deeply concerned.
You seem deeply aroused.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, that was super, like,
I haven't felt your touch in 40 years.
Oh my God. Wow. I almost wonder, is this something like their minds are the minds of their older selves put into their younger bodies or something? Is that what's happening here? So we look like high school students, but in reality, we're like fucking 50 year olds or some shit. I mean, clearly there was a point where we did see older Juro and older Iori. And I think this is also older Iori, who's here for some reason.
That girl, she always stands a little too close to me. It's awkward. I get really self-conscious all the time. How am I supposed to interact with her?
I mean, to be fair, like, it's, I mean, if you're thinking of yourself in high school, right? You're just hitting, you're getting through puberty, all right? You like girls, and a cute fuck girl just comes to your house and just immediately likes, like, oh, hey, baby, I want to make you some dinner. You're like, you're not going to say no. It's, or at least hard to go be like, well, I mean, that's,
It's like, all right, I'm going to go take a shower. I expect you to join me later.
I mean, it'd be fucking terrifying. Holy shit. When you're young like that, all right? Girls are attractive, but they're also scary. I'm like, ah! These horny feelings of mine terrify me. What do I do with them? Still though, holy shit. I didn't expect her to, the first thing, she just shows up at his house, seemingly looks like she broke in, over there cooking him dinner. They're like, hi, I've never met you before.
Oh, I feel your touch, yeah!
Ah! Anyway, stack of papers.
You forgot these again.
Oh my. Sorry for the trouble. I do appreciate it. Thank you, Karabe-kun.
Well, that saves me a trip. Now, I wonder if Shiba-kun was able to find out.
I guess actually, I think about it, that does sound more like Allegra Clark, doesn't it? Like her regular voice. So like the boss, right? It didn't even really occur to me though until the game brought up that she could potentially be Yori's future self. I think by this point, it's pretty clear that she is. Okay, where do I go? Let's go. It's actually still going? Oh, wait, it is still going. I figured that flashback would be the end of it. Oh, go!
So, what do you plan to do?
Yakushiji.
I've gotten permission from Morimura.
I see. Even if that's the case, it isn't looking good. There's an issue with Juro's condition. We can't let it continue as is.
You still plan on using him, don't you? You can't. I won't let you.
Damn, she's protective of him.
Please, let him be free of the Sentinel.
As of now, he's the only one who can fight. I can't promise anything. I recognize the position you're in. You harbor feelings for him, correct? But you must understand that he is no longer the Izumi you knew.
Izumi?
He is Juro Karabe. You would do well to consider him an entirely different person. The new personality is not stable. Don't disregard the danger this may put you in.
Juro will recover. I'll make sure of it.
Even if we erase the personality of Juro Karabe...
What?
It would be a futile effort, as I've already explained.
He's like, what?
Izumi's memory is gone. There is nothing left. You're a difficult one. This is for your own good.
Just let me be.
I cannot. You must return to Shikishima.
And what if I say no?
I know I can move, but I want to listen.
You're a difficult one.
Okay, they're gonna loop. Here we go.
Izumi.
For your own good.
Haven't I heard that name before? I think Shinonome-senpai called me that.
You must return to Shikishima.
And I saw it at the nurse's office.
Yeah, okay, so this takes place after that.
There was a document labeled Juro Izumi.
You're a difficult one.
I thought I was gonna flash back again.
This is
hey guys, what's up?
Just let me be.
Karabe.
Juro.
Heard all that.
How long have you been listening?
Long enough. So what we get for talking out in the open like this? He just shoves him aside. I'm not dealing with this.
What was that about?
No, nothing?
Who is Izumi?
I'll cook one of your favorite meals tonight.
Damn it! I saw an answer!
So please, come right home, okay? No eating out.
Unless it's me!
Oh, God, what? Sorry. I'm sorry. They put it out there and I had to do it. I had to say, I'm sorry!
I'm a different person? Juro Izumi?
Dimitri?
That's ridiculous. And yet, why do I have this sinking feeling? It's like the one Yakushiji has feelings for isn't me. It's Izumi.
And that makes Juro sad because he thought a girl finally liked him. No! Ooh, 50% cleared. Juro Kubabe. I get an achievement for that. Cool. Okay. Okay, definitely getting the idea behind it. So clearly Yakushiji's also there to keep an eye on him. But Goto is like, well, I don't know if she's supposed to be doing that. I think Goto sounds like he's like, you should be leaving him alone. It seems kind of weird because like, in one hand, clearly Yakushiji wants him to move on and not be attached to the Sentinel, right? But Goto is like, we need him for the fight. So it sounds like she wants him to stay as the Juro Kurabe. But on the other hand, if she asked him to be Juro Izumi again, which is the person that clearly she was in love with, then that would probably be like bringing back the fighter, right? The person tied to the Sentinel. I feel like Yakushiji's behavior is slightly paradoxical, but I get it. She wants Izumi without the Sentinel, but it can't happen. So I'm thinking this other one is likely going to be if I go to the nurse's office straight away with the papers. I don't know, maybe all these other paths here are gonna just lead straight to like 100%, like that'll be it, I don't know.
I tried asking her about that talk she had on the stairs.
Hmm.
But she just dodged the question. She had a sad look on her face.
Yeah. This again suggests that it's another day, a different day. All right, let's get the papers. All right, take the papers, get the fuck out of here. Okay, this time we'll go straight to Morimura's office. Run away, Axie, he's right there, run, Juro!
The nurse's office, I should use the others.
Ah, fuck! Watch out, I gotta run past her! Run! Hey, it's the bandage girl! I was wondering if I was gonna run into her.
Guess Miss Morimura's not here.
I haven't seen her one time in the story, anywhere. Until destruction. Oh, Shinome. She's the Shinome one. That's right. He brought before he thought Shinome was the one that had mentioned that Izumi name, right? Hey, girl.
Shinonome, senpai.
What happened to her? Was she all bandaged up?
Izumi-kun?
Yeah?
I'm so glad you're safe.
Oh.
I heard terrible things. So, I thought...
Huh?
Senpai, my name is Kurabe. Juro Kurabe.
Yeah.
That's right.
I think I heard that she was this girl was voiced by, 2B. 2B's voice actress.
Since she's not around, I'll just leave the surveys on her desk.
Throw this shit here.
I'm sure she'll see them when she gets back.
Like a juror just kind of rolls all this shit off like, all right, it's fine. You know, just another day of people mistaking me for this other guy. Sure it's nothing, though. Oh, checking the Juro Izumi thing here.
Huh. They're gone. Last time, she had documents on Juro Izumi here.
Yeah.
I guess she put them away. So you know him too? Juro Izumi?
Juro Izumi is you. But right now, you've been given a different personality.
Given? By who?
The two of us lost our memories after a certain incident. We suffered serious mental trauma.
Ooh, okay.
Especially you.
She did as well.
I heard that you had it worst of all. But I'm not so well off either. My memories keep disappearing. I'm not sure if I'll even remember this conversation.
That's why when she woke up, she immediately was like, oh, Izumi, but she forgot that she's not supposed to say anything, probably. Interesting. Is this, again, due to the brain overload shit, maybe?
What was this incident?
It happened in the future. But you received medical treatment here. Back in the past.
The future?
No should you be telling him this?
It's true. And you're Juro Izumi.
So, let me get this straight. Juro Izumi came from the future. He lost his memories due to some incident. And the damage was so bad he needed a whole new personality. That's how he became me. Juro Kurabe. It's so hard to believe. But if it's true, that would explain why I kept feeling like something was off.
I'm thinking that is the case, and like you stayed in the robot for too long, right? Like maybe he fought too hard, stayed in there for too long, and then they took him out and he was like just totally fucked up, so they had to start from scratch again. The thing is, it seems like this has happened to a lot of other people, right? Because Iori's having dreams of other realities and stuff, in other versions of herself, supposedly, or about the past, I think. I don't know, is it dreams? Are they having dreams about things that they've done, that they actually did, or is she dreaming about other versions of herself, like different timelines? I'm thinking because Amaguchi, Iori, and himself are having these dreams, I'm thinking they're all going through the same thing. And actually, they all have different names. Their own names are actually something totally different. The real names, more than likely. Terrible dream.
The dream was awful.
Oh, wait, I saw that already.
That was a real memory.
Oh.
Does that mean I actually did all that?
Oh, we actually had additional dialogue for it. Cool. I'm so glad you guys mentioned the fast forward thing, using it on these. That actually is going to make this a lot easier to keep track of.
This is crazy. Honestly, it's really hard for me to believe.
I don't blame you.
Okay, I'm getting the shit out of here. Bye. Uh-oh.
Whoa, you're still here?
Shiba-kun, what's up?
I couldn't find Amiguchi anywhere, so I thought I'd come looking for you.
You okay?
Are you all right?
No, I'm not. And neither are you.
Ew. Does that have to do with Shiba?
Well, guess that's that. Let's call it a day and go home.
Give up and go home.
Freaking Amiguchi. You're not getting away from me tomorrow.
What a dickhead. The fact that he's doing this every single day of school, too, just makes it even worse, alright? I didn't actually get anything new from this. Oh, what? Huh? Unlock conditions. Protagonist with story progress at 30% or over 9. Oh, I can't see anymore. Jurokurabe accidentally heard the conversation between Megumi and Yakusiji and Ren Yagoda. He's troubled by the fact that there's another version of himself that goes by the name Juro Izumi. Oh, yeah. So, actually, I don't think my percentage went up at all either. I don't think. I think it cut me short on that one. No, I can't even. So, you're telling me I can't even go back and see what some of these other ones are? Bitch! Oh, interesting. I could have just skipped past this part here. Got straight to that. I actually almost wonder if... Is it because I got too high with his? Or I could have... Or is it because I hit potentially another ending point here, right? Like, this would lead to, like, the next day or some shit. I don't know. But I can't even go back in there now. Bitch. I want to see what these other ones were. Oh, well. Okay. Should I continue with the Iori stuff? I guess so. I mean, seemingly she only has one more choice of food. Okay. Ignore the cat, all right? The cat fucking sucks, and it's not leading me anywhere. Oh, wait, 2089.
2089. That's what year it was in my dream.
Right.
He said he'd gone back in time 16 years to find me.
Yeah, for some reason, it's just an analysis that that year was 1985, which I think is wrong.
In the year 2105. That's 120 years from now.
That's some crazy bullshit, man!
Is wonderful, Asami-chan. Even just
okay, don't let the cat see you.
It's like your heart... Hey, they're not looking...
Okay.
Romance aside, I'm still up. Let's get more...
Yeah! Get more treats! Yeah, let's do it!
Good idea. Where should we go? I'd love to go back to that one place. It's a hot day. Why don't we get some... Nah, I'd rather have... Let's let Iori...
Okay, this time we're having freaking having crepes today. I'm sorry, Miyoko.
Crepes sound good right now.
We had soft serve yesterday.
Let's go.
It's all right. Miyoko doesn't care. She's like, all good. It's all yummies. Ooh, yummy. Damn, those things are huge, though.
Chocolate banana, right?
Double strawberry was half off. I have to try it. Yum.
Let's
see. How is it? So many strawberries.
So many all over me, brah.
Lots of cream.
I eat the paper too.
Tuna and mayo. I could have fed it to the cat.
Hey, cats can't have crepes. I actually have cat treats with me.
What the hell? Why didn't you bring that up earlier?
Him, give him those.
What the fuck?
So you're the one who's been feeding them? Jeez.
The whole time I've been chasing after the cat, Miyoko, you could have... You given them treats?
I'll keep that in mind next time I see one.
Do you know how many fucking time loops I wasted on that shit? Motherfucker. Okay, we got it. We got the cat treats. Here we go. Gonna get Mr. Kitty.
Goto-senpai's pretty cute too.
All right, dickhead.
Even some of the
motherfucker, take this.
Yeah,
Do it.
Now's the time. I'll use Miwa-chan's treats.
Do I have to get close enough?
All the guys at school suck.
Fuck!
I don't see it.
Piece of shit. Do I have to get it from Miyoko? That's probably what it is. Fuck. Fast forward. Fucking cat.
Oh, it's over there.
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Men,
call out. Oh fuck. Call out. I saw it. Wow. This one is weird, man. Getting this one to work right is super weird. So I have to walk back, hit triangle to call out. But if I walk too far, it doesn't work. Fucking hell. Okay, and then I have to reset again, because if I stay here, it doesn't work. I actually have to talk to her, get him back to boys.
Maybe, but come on.
Then get surprised with a cat again. Okay, call out. Yeah, that's a weird one.
Over here.
To get this one to work.
Oh, one moment.
Toss them this way. The kitty treats. Mr. Kitty, we finally have found you. Yes, I know. I'm fucking great.
They're very similar, but I think
I'm also a professor at Harvard. Wow, Mr. Kitty, you went to college?
You got a good look at the one at school, huh? At the front gate with Karabe? Oh, you saw that? That guy's kind of weird, don't you think?
He's kind of weird.
What were you talking to him about? It was...
Let's recall. What was I talking to him about?
It wasn't about boys again.
I was talking to boys about boys?
Yeah.
Sure. Sure, Miyoko. Sure.
It's only 8:10 a.m. Behold, Iori Fuyusaka. Genuine morning person.
Behold!
It's not so bad if I put my mind to it.
Today's a good day.
Oh, kitty.
There's the kitty.
Early cat gets the mouse, huh?
What you doing there, Mr. Kitty?
I'm not Mr. Kitty.
Good morning, Fuyusaka-san.
Quiet.
Ooh, new song, I think.
Huh? Oh, a cat.
He sleeps.
Looks just like a stray I've seen by my house.
It's the same fucking cat.
No, it's the same cat. It's the same demon cat who may or may not be Satan.
Kurabe-kun, you still have those dreams?
Yeah, sometimes.
I have them too. You know that one you talked about earlier? With the UFO buried underground?
Hmm.
UFO?
Oh.
Iori! Morning.
Oh, yeah, she's over there too. Uh-oh. Yakushi, she's getting jealous.
Good morning. What were you guys up to over there? Oh, just looking at a cat.
Yakushi, she pulls out some fucking scissors and goes at Iori's jugular.
Can we talk a little more?
Okay. Megumi?
Yep. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, God. Okay. Jumping back again. Recalling UFO. So this clearly is taking place, I think, after she and Amaguchi and Juro talked about the dream some more, right? I'm going to bet, at least. All right. Now the UFO. Tell me about the UFO dream. Memory of a dream. 300 meters underground spaceship ruins. The fuck?
And now I'm in an entirely different game.
Now I'm playing Odin's Sphere. What the hell?
Juro.
Oh, thank goodness. I was worried with you all by yourself.
Juro, Izumi again.
If something were to happen to you, I...
Juro, stop.
I just want to be friends.
I'm flattered you feel that way.
Ooh.
But I can't think about this. Not now. I don't want to leave you hanging.
No, I get it. I don't know what got into me. This is no time for a confession. It would only make things more complicated.
Curse these teenage horny thoughts.
Listen, when this is all over, I'll talk to you again. Promise.
Better boy.
Hey!
There it is again.
Okino.
Were you able to find the source of these tremors?
Okino-kun.
Tsukasa Okino.
Remember the kaiju that were immobilized? They're starting to collapse. The tunnel is blocked. We'll need to find another route to the surface.
There's no use rushing. No one's left up there anyway.
You don't have to say it.
Hmm.
So you remember. I'm so sorry about your mother.
It's okay. Our work here is a good distraction.
Uh-oh.
I'll check the terminal over there. This one block of data is still being analyzed. It's been 3 days and it's only at 1.2%.
Jesus, this is a long download.
That's unusually dense. Still, the system's logical structure, it's not so far off from our own.
This is like inside one of the terminals?
Right all along?
Or something else?
This could be a relic of an ancient civilization.
I mean, they say UFO, but what? Aliens, huh? I guess, I guess the kaiju themselves could potentially be aliens too. No, man.
I wonder what this is for.
Something incredible, surely. If you asked me for my best guess, I'd say it's a transmission device. In other words, a teleporter. Don't give me that look. Hear me out. I actually found some associated data.
Come on, you've taken quantum mechanics. Transmission of matter isn't possible.
That's what our science says.
Apparently we've all taken quantum mechanics.
Alien technology is bound by the same constraints.
Okay.
If my theory is correct, we've got an explanation for the disappearances. Including those of your parents, Morimura-san.
Guys, come take a look at this.
The disappearance of her parents? So that's what he meant by... He was saying her mother? Wasn't that she died, that she disappeared? They get beamed up or something?
This took some time, but I found this.
What is that?
The map. This relic is enormous.
It's 30 kilometers in diameter.
Looks like Midgar.
And the whole thing's underground, right beneath the city.
It's the size of the UFO, gotcha.
Giant saucer.
Fascinating. So this isn't just any alien facility. It's a buried UFO.
Buried UFO.
We're only 300 meters from the surface. This facility is huge. How could it have never been discovered?
It's not likely. Rather, it may have been intentionally hidden.
A government cover-up of alien life. Sounds like a movie from the 20th century.
Those monsters on the surface. Are they trying to unearth this UFO?
Just what are they after?
So the Kaiju were looking for this, potentially?
It may have something to do with this.
The hell? Is it counting down?
It's a data signal being emitted by this facility as we speak. What does it look like to you?
A countdown.
This is...
Right?
A countdown.
Yeah.
It started when the Kaiju came in contact with the mainframe.
Ooh.
Since then, the clock's been ticking.
To doomsday! I mean, looks like it's gonna be a while before it gets to wherever it's going.
We should investigate further.
So when the countdown reaches zero...
We all die!
What happens?
It may be related to the gravity wave abnormality.
Do you think it might... launch?
Let's just continue the analysis. There's no time for what-ifs. We need to find out what's going on.
The fuck, man? Iori Fuyusaka unlockable. What? What do you mean unlockable? I'm already playing her! Oh, protagonist selection. So, like, another day or something? Because that was it. Those were her two little branches there, right? Unlockable. Oh, wait. Oh. Unlock edition. Unseal 3 mystery files. Oh, that's what it meant. Okay. So now I can continue. Wow, just like that, it went from... She didn't have very many. Now she's up to 42%. Unlock. Can I resume Iori Fuyusaka's story? So I wonder where I would continue from then. Interesting. Okay, so in order to do Juros, I gotta unlock other characters. I don't even have 9 characters yet. Wonder how I unlock everybody else. Fuck. What do you want from a game? Okay, I could continue with Iori, but I think I'm gonna move on to somebody else here. We have dealt a lot with Yakushiji already. We've got A and his weird memory lapses. Good old Nat-chan. I did want to get back to Takatoshi too, but I haven't even unlocked Nenji yet to do it. Shiamaguchi, yeah! I think I kind of want to do A for a bit, honestly. I kind of want to do somebody like that's not... like directly connected to the other characters yet. Like, I feel like Yakushiji could also be one I could easily just jump into because she's, you know, clearly connected with Juro and stuff. But I think I want to do somebody sort of we haven't seen a whole lot of. That's A, so.
Looks like I've lost them for now.
Lost the men in black. Damn, look at the lighting.
My next moves carefully.
Okay. Got quite a few things to consider here. From another world.
So I'm from another world? I said so in that message to myself. Must have still had my memories when I left it. I also said something about a way to escape this world. Details about the dead woman I found. Chihiro Morimura, 31. Sakura High School nurse. Sakura High School? Isn't that where the ID card came from? Sakura High School, Class 1B. Iori Fuyusaka. She definitely looks familiar.
Looks a lot like that lady.
Where? Why can't I remember? Maybe if I find this Fuyusaka person, I'll finally remember something.
Hmm.
Come in.
Oh.
Are you there?
Who the fuck?
Don't be a fool.
Answer, ignore. Ooh, interesting. Answer.
Who are you?
Just a friend who's trying to help out.
Is that Mr. Kitty's voice?
A friend?
I didn't expect you to be so thorough. Regardless, you handled the Morimura assignment well.
So you're the one who wrote those instructions. I can't remember anything.
That's exactly why I've contacted you. Listen, it's not safe out there. Don't trust anyone.
Not even me.
Anyone? Including you?
Better to be too careful than too careless.
Yep.
Otherwise, you'll never escape from this world.
Well, there's two drunk guys behind me.
Escape.
They're ties on their head.
In the meantime, just stay put and don't go far. I'll see what I can do about your pursuers.
I think that is Mr. Kitty's voice. Potentially. It's kind of hard to tell with the...
It disconnected.
The stack from the device.
Don't trust anyone, huh? He mentioned an escape. Like I did in that message to myself. Should I really just wait for him to contact me again? No. He said not to trust anyone. And that includes him.
I'm gonna trust his word on that.
Both the victim and the owner of this ID card. They're from Sakura High School. Maybe this female student knows something I don't.
Cool. Find Iori Fuyusaka. Sure.
Once day breaks, I'll pay a visit to the school.
I'm gonna find her. A.M. Sakura High School front gate.
Sounds like school just started.
I'm so...
Oh, this is the moment where... Oh, wait. No, never mind. That's not Sean.
Crap. I need to drop by the track room first.
She's got a cut on her face or something. That's maybe the moment Iori runs into him by accident.
No sign of her.
Or maybe it is. Nope. She doesn't have a toast in her mouth.
Akon.
Iori Fuyusaka.
Hmm. Okay, she remembers him, so this is clearly, I think, taking place after that, right? There's Mr. Kitty again!
I haven't seen you in days. I couldn't stop thinking about you.
Hey, baby!
But now?
Oh, shit.
I'm just relieved to see her safe.
We're going steady?
Seems like we're close. Very close.
Hmm.
But I can't trust anyone.
Not even her.
For now, I'll act like I remember her. I want to hear what she has to say first.
Damn, I guess they're... Are they going steady at this point?
Iori, was there something you wanted to tell me?
Huh? Well...
I love you.
Like I said before, I still like you.
Aw.
Even if it is one-sided.
Oh. Awkward. He's like, oh, I don't know what to say to that. So apparently even when he did know who she was, it was still one-sided. Ah!
Can't catch a break!
ID card.
This belonged to you?
Oh, that's my student ID. I thought I'd lost it. But I'm glad you were there to find it for me. Thank you.
All right, where were we? Oh yeah, that makeout session. Let's go. Please.
There's not enough games characters to make out with each other. Fuck. By the way, you know what this empty pill bottle is?
Do these pills belong to you?
Pills? No, those aren't mine. Wait, aren't those the pills you've been taking?
Oh yeah, I mean, oh, yeah.
My mistake. These are mine.
I love pills. Yummy, yummy.
Are you sick?
I don't know.
I'm fine. It's nothing to worry about.
Allergies. Just allergies.
Chihiro Morimura. She's the school nurse.
Do you recognize this dead body?
Huh? Yeah, she is. What about her?
She's fucking dead.
What if... Ever since that day, she hasn't come back to school. Could something have happened?
Which day?
The day I heard about Miss Morimura's secret.
I'm sure she's fine.
That you, she's you from the future?
Morimura's secret.
Yeah.
We must accept our fate.
Huh?
That's not good.
Here come Men in Black!
It's that same dude, too. it's just one guy.
It's okay. He's gone.
Thanks.
I'm a badass, what can I say? He always like, I'm happy to help.
Oh no. My first class is about to start. What will you do now, Akun?
I'm gonna pay a visit to the nurse's office.
But those men, won't they be on campus too?
I'll be alright, I've got a gun.
Why don't you meet me here after school's out? I'll show you where to go.
Underneath the bleachers. All right.
I'll see you later.
I love you.
It's like, oh God, why do I gotta be such a ladies' man?
We must accept our fate. That's what Chihiro Morimura said. It's hazy, but I think I remember.
Ah, okay. Oh, recall. Going even further back. Oh, damn, look at that booty. Seriously, holy shit. Flashback for the Kaiju invasion. 2064.
So this is where you've been.
I figured I'd give the area an advanced survey.
Quite the view. Worth taking in one last time.
Now who is this?
Right.
I expect there to be considerable damage.
Older version of somebody?
Them in Sector 1.
Is it Goto?
There was nothing we could do. But not this time. We will fend them off.
I certainly hope so.
We've managed to prepare 19 Sentinels. And we've had
positive
results
too many.
In our battle simulations.
That won't mean much if our enemies have evolved.
No.
It seems our victory ultimately depends on luck.
This is sounds like the guy on the walkie-talkie.
So let's assume we're met with the worst-case scenario. If we fail this time, we'll perform another loop.
Oh.
And we'll start over from the very beginning.
Just keep doing this time loop shit until
we'll
we get it right.
Chance of success that way.
Even if it means leaving this world behind. No. No more running away.
Yeah, it's definitely some world line shit going on here.
Then I'm initiating Operation Aegis.
So you intend to close the loop then? If you do, no one will be able to leave.
At the very least.
Oh, interesting.
We'll survive.
You expect us to grow old and die in this godforsaken place.
When that time comes, We must accept our fate.
In any case...
Yes. If we win now, we can avoid such an outcome.
Is that A?
We'll finally be able to
he heard her world. Say that. Oh, no, there he is.
Sekigahara-kun.
How long have you been standing there?
I was like, how did he know it? Okay.
Closes the loop, huh? So they're stuck in a time loop, really. Like, continuously doing this? But the Aegis system does that?
So, like, they won't get destroyed by the Kaiju. They'll just keep doing it again and again, but never be fully killed off, potentially. I gotta check the timeline, too. I haven't checked that in a while to see where a lot of this stuff lays out.
I don't know who you people are or where you came from. And frankly, I don't care. Just as long as you can defend my city from the Kaiju. Without retreating, that is.
You'll be the one in the Sentinel protecting the city. We're counting on you.
Well, I assume you have some questions for me.
Yeah, who the fuck are you?
Tetsuya Iida? What? Tetsuya Iida?
That was the other name for Shua Maguchi.
What?
This definitely does not look like Shu. Unless Tetsuya Iida is like transferring his mind into Shu, unless Shu's hair gets dark. Or maybe it's just the lighting of the night.
There's something I need to confirm. If I keep my end of the bargain, then you're gonna stop using Ryoko-senpai, right?
Please understand, I never had any intention of using her.
Ryoko, okay.
I'll try to be more careful going forward.
That's Bandage Girl, I believe, right?
For the Sentinels you want command over, you require third generation machines, right?
Correct.
Then I'll update their systems as promised. Though I have to ask, why are you having me do this? Wouldn't it be faster to go directly through Morimura?
I believe a shift in the chain of command is in order.
Oh.
And I'd like it to be done without her knowledge.
Working behind her back, okay.
Depending on how the situation unfolds, there's a possibility she may resort to drastic measures.
Is that what she was just talking about? This Operation Aegis?
That's right.
Close the loop. What are they talking about? Are they planning on abandoning the city? No. I can't let that happen. I need more details on this so-called operation.
Yeah. I think closing the time loop, right? That's what they mean. But I think it's also meaning like, they're saying they're abandoning this world line, basically.
Operation Aegis. What is its purpose?
The enemy's main target is the underground mainframe. Each terminal is equipped with a self-defense protocol. However, the enemy's attacks seem to bypass it. So the moment they strike, we'll hack the terminal. This will activate the defense protocol. The Aegis system.
Isn't that a good thing?
Not exactly. Doing so will render our time machine useless.
Oh.
And that means we can never start over again.
Oh, that's what it means. Okay.
What's bad about that?
Okay.
It doesn't matter as long as we succeed, right?
Hmm.
Time will cease to flow in this world.
Oh.
When it does, everything will descend into chaos.
Oh, that's interesting.
And in the end, we'll be the only ones left behind in this hellscape.
Oh, this is a big plot reveal right here. Oh, that's a big revelation right there. What the Aegis system is and what activating it causes to happen. And that's what we've been doing. We've been activating the Aegis system everywhere. Because that means we're halting time, basically. And we won't be able to use our time machines anymore.
Ooh. Cool. Ah, oh, fuck, I'm locked already! What?
Oh, this is a straight line. There was actually no paths on his.
Damn, that was a big one. Shit.
Now I'm locked until I complete Nasuno shit. So, okay, there's definitely some linear, and like, it looks like, it gives you the idea that you can like go anywhere you want, but there's a point where it's gonna stop you until you finish somebody else's, because they want me, they still have a fair amount of storytelling, right? That like, okay, plot points, there's still moments where you don't want to know this plot point before this other plot point. Nasuno Manami's exterminator. All right, let's have a look at the analysis here. All events, the final countdown. Oh wow, this is actually the earliest scene I've found so far, was this UFO thing. Three teenagers discover an ominous countdown, what seems to be the ruins of an alien ship. Interesting. Operation Aegis. Okay, this is also fairly early on. The boy from the future. This is where Juro comes in at some point. Okay, so when did this happen? This happened after they talk about the dreams, right? Yup. It absolutely did. It actually happened right after the one we saw last episode where they were talking about Sumire Bridge. Was when she met up with Juro and talked about the UFO. Okay, cool. Uninvited housewife, kind of in the middle-ish here. Oh, interesting. Before he went over to the to Amaguchi's house that one time, he actually came across the Yakushiji and Goto having that conversation on the stairs. That happened right before this. So that's probably something else that was on his mind while he was here. Okay, A stuff has been kind of going in an order here. So, message myself, counting on student ID. So he pretends he still has his memories. I do wonder, because the beginning is the beginning of the final fight, right? So I wonder if the stuff that takes place afterwards is just stuff that's gonna be unlocked after you beat like battles or what exactly? I'm guessing probably. At some point you'll probably start getting some cutscenes after the destruction fights. Actually, it's interesting. I can't actually get to 30% on A's yet. For Juro's thing. Well, I guess in that case, since it unlocks after Natsumi's thing, or Minami's thing, let's go do her thing. She got transported to the future. She's still there? Are we hopping back yet, or? I think they might have come back.
Aw, oh, jeez. You really gotta stop doing this. Sentinel number 17. Created to fight against the tripods. It's also the robot that BJ used to pilot.
Oh. Really? BJ? This little Wally dude who used to pilot the Sentinel?
His name is BJ. He's an alien that came from a highly civilized planet. His mission was to protect Earth from other evil aliens.
Oh. You figured that all that stuff out? Okay. Yeah, I'm guessing, holy shit, look at all, she's got a lot of options here. Yeah, so clearly they must have just jumped back. He wanted to show her what the world, you know, what his mission was, right? That shit happens, and then they jump back.
Buddy.
Buddy!
You gotta stay quiet if we're gonna keep you hidden.
Let's go. Let's go to the gate.
I'm almost done with practice. We'll go there after. Sound good?
Gate.
Let's go. Gate, must go. Do it, bitch.
I do feel bad locking you up in here, but I don't know where else to keep you safe.
Hiding place.
It's like I told you this morning.
Remember. I guess you brought him to school again, right? Yeah, in the back.
I'm sorry, BJ.
So cute.
But if I left you in my room, my brothers would come in.
Okay, she got brothers.
I'd be able to find you even if you were hiding.
Beep beep.
Once school's over, I'll help you find what you're looking for. You just gotta be a good boy until then, okay? Shh. You gotta stay quiet or those men in black will find
you. Natsuno, feed me!
They really do seem to be everywhere.
I want ice cream! I love you!
come back during break. Just stay quiet until then, okay? So you're gonna be a good little alien, right? That means you gotta stay in there. I'm sorry I have to make you wait.
It's claustrophobic in here.
I'll be back soon. My room gets raided by my little brothers pretty often.
Ooh, thinker.
Either way, I can't leave BJ at home. As for the track room, no one goes in there until after school. If I put him in my locker, odds are no one would see him. His name is he's an alien that came from his mission was to protect Earth.
I don't know, maybe this is before she went into the future. I'm not really sure, to be honest. I guess we'll have to see on the timeline, right? All right, let's get out of here. Uh-oh.
Oh, not again. Natsuno?
Oh.
Oh, hi.
He's entered Toy Story, Toy Story box mode.
That box on the floor. It's yours, right?
Why?
You always put it in your locker.
Oh, you saw.
You didn't see nothing. You have to die now.
It isn't, anyways. A clock?
Yes.
What it is, well.
A robot friend!
It's a secret.
Oh, I get it. Another silly UFO thingamajig. Whatever. Just put it away before Senpai sees.
Not Senpai.
Oh boy.
It was cramped in there. You can't blame me.
You're going in the box.
I'm already a box.
She's gone now.
Beep boop. Little buddy.
We must go to the gate.
Get in the back.
If BJ is about to be seen by someone, I'll just hide him in my PE bag. Crisis averted.
Yeah.
I gotta be careful. This is confidential information, after all.
I'm the hero of time and space! Get in there, little buddy!
You don't have any idea, do you? What would happen if they found you?
I don't either, actually.
Area 51. Dissected on a table.
Get out of here. Before Will Smith shows up. Where the hell is that alien? Damn it, Wally. We can't let you stop global warming.
Hold it right there.
Crap.
I'm going to need you to show me what's inside your bag.
Shut up, Felix.
Stop.
Damn, that escalated quickly.
He's still after me.
Probably no one on campus gives a shit these guys and guys in black are walking around. Run, girl. Walking slowly. Where could she have gone? Oh, she's still at the opposite end of the hallway. How does he not see me? Oh, okay.
This really sucks.
Oh, wait. Go downstairs. This girl can run. Different looking guy.
There's someone over here too.
I'm gonna high kick him. Break his fucking neck.
Hey, how's it going?
Hold it right there.
Bad end. I would actually reset it. Okay, what do I do? Go out the window. I guess go elsewhere. The hallway again.
What do I do?
Is that guy still over there? Yeah, yes, I'd say so.
Well, then what the hell am I supposed to do, huh?
Go in the classroom? Oh.
Well, if it isn't Minami.
Oh, God, Takun.
What's up?
Neji! Take the... take out this guy!
I'm being chased by men in black suits.
Perverts! They must die!
What'd they do?
Nothing yet. But if they catch us, who knows? Dissection, maybe. Definitely a full body search.
Full body? So those clothes will probably be in the way.
Huh?
You know, that little outfit.
Oh my god!
Outfit? You mean the spacesuit? Well, yeah. They'd take the whole thing off. I imagine they'll search every nook and cranny.
For real?
For real?
Those lucky mother. I mean, those sick.
But how dare they? Every nook and butthole. I'll just like I've been safe for all these years. Yeah, take out the perp. I knew it.
Hey, you ain't getting away with this, ass.
No, only I'm allowed to search every suspicious looking buck and butthole. He got knocked the fuck out.
Never seen someone go down so easily.
Oh my god.
It came from over there.
Never seen someone go down so easily.
Well, so much for that.
Well, that was something.
Good job, Nenji.
Crap.
You did good. He didn't do anything. okay. Encountering Okata. He really helped. You did so good.
Someone was just here.
The hell are you doing here?
Oh!
Yuki-chan?
Now here comes a real badass.
Good timing. I could really use your help.
What now?
We've been pursuing a suspicious individual. She's still in the area and she's concealing something.
A bag.
If I just help him out now, maybe old Four Eyes will let me have my way. Fine.
Goto?
It's an SIU assignment anyway, right? That's why I was hired to go undercover in the first place.
Oh!
All you have to do is locate her. Leave the capture to us.
Oh, interesting.
So, what does she look like?
They're actually working together.
She's like, ah, shit.
There's no way. Is Yuki-chan working with the men in black?
One of them!
Yuki-chan.
Yuki-Takamiya. Rut-ro. My best friend's meddling. Hey! There we go. So I actually had a feeling that it might unlock hers after that. I was like, oh, we just learned a big thing about her.
Papa Squat!
Oh yeah, I guess I'll have to go through a prologue too, because I haven't even seen that yet.
Papa Squat!
Why she wears the long skirt, right? She goes around, she's kicking ass. She kicks people in the face. I want to make sure you don't see her panties, right? All right, so have a look at the analysis again. Oh yeah, to make sure things are updated here. Woman who looks like Murimura. In truth, she is the woman he knows as Miss Murimura. Yes, the person who looks like Iori Fuyusaka. I find this was kind of funny though. Just like the literal description of this is woman who looks like Miss Murimura. She's from Shu's dream. It looks like Miss Murimura. This woman appears in Juro Krabbe's dream. In truth, she is the woman who knows Miss Murimura. What a revelation! Time travel. You could travel to 5 eras. Ooh, this is new. You can travel to 5 eras. 1945, 1985, 2025, 2065, and 2105. So 40-year increments every time. Interesting. Operation Aegis. By hacking the underground mainframe computer at the moment the Kaiju attack, the terminals Aegis system, the self-defense system, will be force activated. As a result, the terminals will automatically attack and destroy all Kaiju. However, activating the Aegis system will render the time machines useless, preventing the user from resetting the timeline. Instead, they will be left behind to survive in the ruins of their destroyed world. So that's sort of the risk of it, right? They won't be able to undo it. But also, it seems like be a hidden after effect of also time will refuse to move forward or something, right? Unless I misunderstood that, I don't know. I'll have to check that back when I go back and edit. UFO. Also called a saucer. Giant circular structure with a diameter of 30 kilometers. Is 300 meters underground in Ashitaba City. Okay. So, Natsumo Nami is just to a devastated city with BJ. So yes, this definitely happened before whenever this other event is. My best friend's meddling. Here we go. So they just came back. Actually, I just realized too, I'm getting meta chips from these things, which means I can further unlock stuff here. Yeah, get more things. In that case, let's get the fucking chip multiplier. I get to level 3 again too. I'm guessing this is only gonna affect though the battles. I don't think this is gonna affect getting him in the story. Well, all right, guys, we definitely uncovered some really good stuff on this episode though. Finally learned what the Aegis system was, which is good, or at least got some details on it to better understand it. And also a little bit about the mind erasure stuff, you know? As well as a few glimpses of some of the other characters we haven't learned much about, like Ryoko and Yuki. But this is good. I am still really enjoying this game, and I hope you guys are as well. If you are, please leave a like and a favorite. It really does help me out. And subscribe if you're not already, become Piggy Penguin for the SLP. Where the days are always sunny and the vids are always funny. And as always, guys, till next time, stay classy!